So I get a lot of questions about the Do Not Disturb feature on the iPhone. A lot of people like the idea of your phone being quiet at night and not bothering you with notifications, but they're worried that they're going to miss something important, an important phone call or text message from someone they care about or from work when it's important, that kind of thing. Well, there are ways to make sure that certain people can get through to you even with Do Not Disturb turned on. So let's take a look at it. First of all, the easiest way to turn on Do Not Disturb manually is to bring up Control Center. And when you bring up Control Center, you can just tap the little crescent moon there. But for the most part, Do Not Disturb is used automatically. So you go into the settings, and under Do Not Disturb, you have the scheduled portion there. And the default will be something like 11 p.m. to 7 a.m. You could change the default anytime you want. So set it to your bedtime and your wake time. Also, when you turn on Do Not Disturb manually, either through the Control Center or through here, it basically turns it on from now till the end of the day through the schedule period, and it turns it off automatically. So if you're going to bed early one night, you can turn it on and then know it's going to go off at the regular time. Now, what happens if you turn it on and somebody needs to get through to you? Well, there's a bunch of different ways they can get through to you. One way is they could just simply be assigned as a favorite contact. So you can see here it says allow calls from. And if you go in there, you can set it to everyone, which is useful because it still silences all the notifications and text messages, but you'll still get phone calls. So if you're like me and you rarely receive phone calls anyway, you may want to use that one. Somebody tries to call you, it'll come through. You could set it to no one, or you could set it to just favorites. You can also set it to a group. You can't assign groups on the iPhone, but you can do it on your Mac, and then it syncs through iCloud. So you can set a work group or an emergency contacts group or something like that, and then just say, I want that group to be able to call me. Now, how do you assign a favorite? Well, the way you do that is you go into contacts, you select a person, and then at the bottom it says add to favorites. And then you select what type of favorite to add. Now the only one that Do Not Disturb cares about is for calling. So you want to turn calling on. Then if you go into the phone app and you tap on favorites, the little star at the bottom left, you can see all of your favorites listed. And this is useful anyway, just to be able to quickly call them. But you can also delete them here as well, so you can get rid of favorites. Another way to do this is to use the emergency bypass. Emergency bypass is really cool. You go into contacts here, and just like before, you select a contact. Now, you won't find emergency bypass anywhere here, or even if you go to edit, you won't find it. But if you tap on the ringtone, so there's the ringtone and the text tone. I'm going to tap on ringtone, and you can see in addition to being able to set a custom ringtone for this person, I can also turn on emergency bypass. And that means their phone calls will come through even if I have Do Not Disturb turned on. Better than that, you can also do the same thing here for their text tone. So now their text messages will come through normally even when Do Not Disturb is turned on. This is really handy because you can do it per contact. So you do the contacts that are most important, or maybe just in one particular case, like during a meeting at work or one particular night, you want to make sure somebody can get in touch with you. Maybe somebody's arriving on a plane that night and you want to make sure they can call you, but you want to have Do Not Disturb on for the rest of it. You can basically enable them to text you, enable them to call you, and then just remember to turn that off later on. So you can do that as kind of a temporary measure to let people through, or just permanent if it's somebody very important to you that you want to make sure Do Not Disturb just does not apply to them for either phone calls or text messages. Now, also notice that there's another way for people to get through to you. If you go back into the Do Not Disturb settings in your settings app, you'll see that there's a setting for repeated calls. And when you turn that on, a second call from the same person within 3 minutes will still get through. So if somebody really wants to get through to you, they're going to try calling twice and it gets through to you even with Do Not Disturb turned on. And you can let people know that this function is on your iPhone. So just tell them, hey, if you ever really need to get in touch with me, if it's an emergency, call me. If I don't pick up and it's like the middle of the night or whatever, just call me again immediately, and the second time I'll actually get the call. So there's various ways for you to bypass Do Not Disturb when it's important.